Hello, so today we are going to learn about English, write it right. So what are the objectives of that? Use dictionary to help select appropriate words for your writing. Apply basic rules that describe when and where to use punctuation such as periods, question marks, commas, semicolons and apostrophes. Identify the parts of speech used in sentences, including nouns, pronouns, verbs, adjectives, conjunctions, preposition, and interjections. Identify sentence fragments and change them into complete sentences, and use several techniques to construct complete sentences from run-on sentences. So, we will go through the smaller introduction. Each person plays a variety of roles in life. You are a friend, a mate, a colleague, an employee, a supervisor, and a representative of your organization. You communicate with a diverse group such as salespeople, suppliers, government representatives, co-workers, and community groups. Much of your success in dealing with other people depends on your choice of words. You must choose words that other people will understand. Words must capture their interest while reflecting your sincerity and objectivity. Equally important, you must make sure that you are using words correctly. In this section, you will learn some simple techniques for expanding your vocabulary. Learning new words allows you to add detail to your documents and speech. Using correct word also makes your writing concise and easy to follow. Using a dictionary provides you with a wealth of information to help you choose, use and spell right word. When in doubt about what word to use or the meaning of the word that you are reading, look it up in your dictionary. A good dictionary gives the following information on a word, usually in this order. The word correctly spelled and with hyphens to show syllable breaks. The pronunciation. Definition of the pronunciation symbols can usually be found at the front of the dictionary. The parts of speech that the word represents, noun, verb, adjective, adverbs, etc. Spelling of alternative forms of the word can be grammatically changed by adding letters at the end. For example, ed, ing, etc. Definition of the word, numbered if there is more than one definition. The first definition is generally the more common. The origin of the word, the etymology, Latin, Greek, French, etc. Other information on synonyms, words of roughly similar meaning, antonyms, words of roughly opposite meaning, usage and alternative spellings. Here is an example of an entry in a dictionary. Consult. So they have been giving the phonetic transcription letters to seek information or advice from. Refer to consult a dictionary for the meaning of a word. Then to exchange ideas. Talk things over. He is consulting with his lawyer to take into consideration how record for a good ruler, consult the interest and feeling of the people. Then consult to talk something over with someone in order to make a decision. So a guide to the basic punctuation. The following section provides some simple rules to follow when using common punctuation such as periods, question marks, exclamation points, commas, semicolons, colons, and apostrophes. English grammar has many more rules for other punctuation not covered in this session. Quotation mark, hyphen, dash, ellipses are all the part of punctuation rules that you may come across in English grammar books. The following is not intended to complete English grammar course. Terminal punctuation. This section will cover the basic punctuation most commonly used to end sentences in business writing. Period. A period is used to indicate the end of the sentence. The sentence is either declarative or imperative. Example, the three boys waited for their mother is a declarative sentence. Wait there, an imperative sentence. Note that you can insert the subject also. You in this command so that it reads you wait there. And so the periods are not used at the end of the sentences within the sentences. Example, the storm I got a glimpse through the curtain was starting to approach. Mary's reply, I do not want to go, was expected. Question mark. The question mark is used to identify a query. These sentences usually start with who, what, where, when, why, or how. Example, who will represent the poor? How do I complete this report without the correct information? When can you get me the information? Question mark should be used at the end of the element that is part of the sentence. Example, how can the two women be reconciled? Was the question on everyone's mind. What for? He wondered. What for? He wondered. As he asked himself, how I am going to pay for this? He noticed a rupee on the ground. Exclamation point. An exclamation point is used to note an emphatic remark. Remember, it should be used sparingly. Used too often, it loses its effect on a reader. Example, look out. Your command certainly lacked tact. Suddenly, the street child looked as if all were lost. In most business writing, you will be making statement of fact, so you will use the period to be more effective in writing a fact. You will be need to join your thoughts together or separate them to make the meaning clear. Sentence function, comma. The comma is by far the hardest punctuation mark to use correctly. Do not insert a comma merely because the sentence is long and you feel there ought to be a comma somewhere. Learn where a comma is required and only use one when you know it is needed. Commas are used when two sentences are joined together by coordinating conjunction. An introductory class, phrase or a word precedes the sentence. Three or more words, phrase or classes are written in a sentence. A sentence is interrupted by a class, phrase or a word that is not part of a sentence structure. A series of coordinating adjectives describe the same noun. And the following pages contain fuller explanation and examples of these rules for using comma. Two sentences are joined together by a coordinating conjunction. Use commas to separate two main class in compound sentence when they are joined by one of the seven coordinating conjunction. And but, for, nor, or, so, yet. Example, Mary wrote the novel and Julie edited. The house burned to ground, but the first station was not notified. An introductory class, phrase or word should be followed by a comma. Common introductory words that should be followed by comma include yes, however, and well. Introductory class that start with certain words including after, although, as, because, if, since, when, while should also be followed by a comma.